Welcome to our video on how to create an exploration, where you will learn how to create a new exploration, use the driver analysis card, use the decision tree card, edit drivers, view related insights, use the assistant, create single card, create comparison card, evaluate starting points, and create a dashboard. To complete these steps, the base samples must be installed. If any of the required objects are missing, please contact your administrator. Here is our Telco Churn dashboard. It shows us some key high-level information about how our phone and internet business is performing. The data set includes information about customers who left within the last month, services that each customer has signed up for, customer account information, and demographic information. In the heat map, we can see that one square is darker than all the others. It looks like the highest values of tenure are associated with customers who have churned. This means that our longest tenured customers are leaving us. Let's create an exploration and see if we can gain any insights. To do that, select the heat map, click Explore in the context toolbar, and select New Exploration. We are brought into the exploration component and a new card is created with the heat map. Our data is brought forward too. On the Sources panel, and if we click on the Explorations icon, we can see our card list. The Details tab is open and displays text that is generated to describe aspects of the data represented in the visualization that are not obvious from looking at it. Correlated insights are displayed as green icons on charts. It shows the top 5 drivers with a statistical strength greater than 66%. If we click on it, in our case, we can see here are the top 5 drivers for tenure. Let's click on the first one. A driver analysis card is created for us for tenure. By default, the strongest driver is selected and shown in the key driver visualizations preview below. This preview is not the real visualization. If you click on it, you are not interacting with it, you are just adding it to the card list. Let's click the plus icon for the decision tree to add it to the card list so that we can look at it again later. And there it is. Each driver or bubble has an influence on the target that is measured by the predictive strength on the horizontal axis. The strongest predictors are on the right and weaker ones are on the left. A target is a variable from your data asset that you want to understand. The target field's outcomes may be influenced by other fields in the data. The color of the bubble shows the different types of drivers. A blue bubble indicates the strength of a particular single driver in affecting your target. These are one-way drivers. Orange bubbles indicate how strong two drivers in combination are in affecting your target. These are two-way drivers. Green bubbles indicate more than two drivers. The size of the bubble indicates the number of drivers within. You can zoom in on overlapping bubbles using your mouse wheel. If we hover over the largest bubble with the strongest predictive strength, we can see that there are 6 potential two-way driver combinations with the same predictive strength of 87%. If we click this bubble, the key driver visualizations preview is updated. We can navigate through each driver combination by clicking on the dots. This one was streaming TV, and this one is tech support. On this third combination, if we click the chart rather than the plus icon, we we add the chart to the card list, and we open it. Let's go back to the decision tree card that we parked earlier and take a closer look. The tree diagram tab is open. A decision tree shows a connected hierarchy of boxes to represent the values of records. Records are segmented into groups, which are called nodes. Each node contains records that are statistically similar to each other with respect to the target field. If we click the top five target values icon, we can see indicators beside the nodes with the five highest target values of tenure. These are the predicted values of the target for that combination of driver value. The decision tree visualization also has a tree sunburst tab. It presents an alternate view of the same data, this time with the hierarchy represented with concentric circles. The circle in the center is the target, and you can follow the hierarchy outward. The rules tab shows us a list of the predicted values for key drivers, arranged from highest to lowest. In this example, the highest predicted value of tenure is 67.76, generated from driver values of total charges greater than or equal to 4,476 and a 2-year contract. If we click the More icon beside the target of tenure and select Edit Drivers, we can customize our analysis. By default, the system chooses a set of drivers for us, to a maximum of 250. Here we can select our own particular set of drivers using this dialog. For example, we can remove drivers that are obvious or redundant, and we can add in other potential influencers of interest. Explore also offers you suggestions in the form of related insights. If we click Related at the top of the screen, we see a list of related visualizations. If we click on one, it is added as a card and opened. IBM Cognos Analytics includes an embedded assistant. That lets you enter text-based input to help you gain quick insights into your data and simplify your analytics. Properly structured text input helps Cognos Analytics understand your request and return the best results. The supported lexicon will expand in future releases, but some commonly used commands are help, show data, show source, show column, what influences column, show column and field, or show column by field. The Compact Assistant panel is available in the exploration interface only. If we type and click Enter, we are presented with several charts and a matching data source. We can flip through the charts to see if any are interesting. This one looks good. Let's create a new card for this visualization by clicking New and selecting Single. If we click on the Compact Assistant again, we can drag this third chart onto the new card. Suppose we only want to see customers without dependents. Let's add a filter to this visualization. To do that, open the Sources panel and drag Dependents onto the Local Filter slot. In the resulting dialog, click No and click OK. The visualization is now filtered to include only customers without dependents. The chart is currently showing the average tenure. To change it to total, click the More icon beside Tenure and select Summarize. click some, and dismiss the dialog. Open the Explorations panel, scroll down, click the More icon for the current card, and select Duplicate. Select both cards holding down Control, click the More icon at the top of the card list, and click Compare. A third new card is created that allows you to compare two visualizations at the same time. With card B selected, scroll down to Local Filters, click the More icon, and click Filter. Click Yes, click No, and click OK. Above each chart, we can see that chart A is showing no dependence and chart B is showing dependence. On the compare card, notice that the axes are synced and maintain the same scale across both charts. If we move our mouse over a chart, we can see a reference line. It displays a visual baseline that helps us compare values across both charts. You can turn it on and off with this icon. A summary of key information and differences between the two visualizations is generated at the top of the screen. You can turn it on and off with this icon. If we select the bar for one-year contracts and DSL, we can see that our selection is synced between the two charts, and the summary table updates. We can configure how objects are synced by clicking Sync and turning options on and off. All the visualizations that we have looked at so far have been based on suggestions from Explore. However, we can still build charts manually ourselves. Let's create a new card by clicking New and selecting Single. Click the Choose a Type button. The available visualizations are organized by type. And in this case, we'll click on Word Cloud. And a new visualization is created, and we can populate it with data. For example, we can drag City onto the Words slot. And we can drag churn score onto the size slot. In this video, we began by launching the exploration feature from a visualization on a dashboard. If we had created an exploration from a data source directly, we would have been brought to the starting points card. To go there now for the current example, open the explorations panel. And click the Starting Points card at the bottom. The Starting Points card shows you the relationships in your data. It provides guidance, almost like a magnifying glass, into your data. It focuses your attention to what the system considers to be the most important fields. The field of interest is the focal point and is represented by a blue circle in the diagram. Related fields are organized into green circles. The relationships between green circles are also shown, not just the relationship to the blue circle. If there is no relationship, the field is not shown. Lines connect the fields and represent relationships. The thickness of the line indicates the strength of the relationship. You can change the field of interest by clicking on a different one. You can interact with the relationship diagram by selecting one or more fields that you are interested in. I'll select churn score and total charges. As you do, the list of suggested starting points to the left of the diagram updates to include the fields you selected. Any of these visualizations can be added to the cards list by clicking the plus icon. Now that we have created some interesting charts, we can reuse any of them in a dashboard using copy and paste. For example, we can click the More icon beside the second card and select Copy. We can create a new dashboard by clicking New and selecting Dashboard. We'll accept the default template and click OK. And here, we can use Control-V to paste that card. And we can see that both the visualization and the underlying data are pasted in. Thank you for watching our video on how to create an exploration. Please subscribe to our YouTube channel to learn more about using IBM Cognos Analytics 11.